viewers for the lecture on structural analysis. In the last few lectures, we have been discussing about cables and suspension bridges. In the first four lectures, we have discussed about analytical procedure. Lecture number 75, we have introduced influence line for 3-inch stiffening girder. And 76, 77, we have done some problems. Right. Now, this is lecture number 78. Now, in the lecture number 76 and 77, we have discussed the procedure, how to draw influence line for uniformly distributed load, influence line for horizontal tension, influence line for bending moment at a section, bending moment at a given section, influence line for shear force at a given section. All these things we have discussed, and also we have done a full problem on how to find out these quantities at a given section using influence lines. Now, that is one type of problem. Finding out the values at a given section is one type of problem. Right. Now, next, the bridge will be generally subjected to moving load. A single constant load move from one end to the other end, or a UDL may move from one end to the other end. Right. When a single constant load moves from one end to the other end of a stiffening girder, say 3-inch stiffening girder, what position of the load will cause the absolute maximum bending moment? We know maximum of all maximum bending moment is called absolute maximum bending moment, because we know for every section there is a maximum bending moment, and of all these values there will be the highest value, that is called the, that is the maximum of maximum bending moment. So when a single load moves from one end to the other end of a 3-inch stiffening girder, what is the absolute maximum bending moment and what should be the load position for the absolute maximum bending moment, right? So that we have to find out, for which also we can find out the influence line. Now, before that, now we know, suppose if you are interested in getting the influence line diagram for this particular section, say, let us say this is X, this is the section for which we want to draw the influence line diagram. So for that, as already we have discussed, so the bending moment at any section, we know, equal to mu x minus h into y. Bending moment as a simply support beam minus bending, the reduction of the bending moment due to the horizontal tension. This already we are aware, right? Now, as a simply supported beam, this we have discussed in the previous class, the bending moment diagram, I mean the ILD for bending moment, will be a triangle having a maximum ordinate of x into L minus x by L. So this we know, x into the maximum ordinate, this is due to a moving point load, moving unit concentrated load, x into L minus x by L, this already we know. So this is the first part, bending moment as a simply support beam, minus there is a reduction due to the horizontal tension. So that will also be a triangle, this at the center, the maximum ordinate will be at the center. Now here, this ordinate is also equal to x into L minus x by L. This also is x into L minus x by L, where x is this value, x is the distance that is measured from the left. So this is the value of x that you have to substitute in this. This is the value in this formula. In both formulas, the x value will be the same, because the influence line diagram is drawn for a particular section. Whatever is the value, whether it is for mu x or minus h into y, it is drawn for a particular section. So we have to substitute this value of x only for this as well as for this, because ILD is drawn for a particular section. So this is mu x minus h into y. So this is mu x, the first diagram. This is mu x. This diagram is h into y. Both belong to a particular section x, for which this is the value of x. That we'll have to remember. This already we have discussed, and also we have applied in a problem. Right. Now, this is due to a moving unit load. A moving unit. This diagram is due to a moving unit load. This is not W. It is moving unit load. Now, in the place of unit load, right, when we apply a value equal to W, when we apply a load equal to W, now if it is for a particular section, here also the value will be W into X into L minus X by L. This is also W into X into L minus X L by L. So this is positive, this is the net ordinate, so this is the net ordinate, net negative ordinate. This is negative, this is positive. Superimposing, you get this diagram, right? So this is net positive, this is net negative. So this is ILD for a particular section, right? Now, when this is a moving load, this can occupy any position from 0 to L, anywhere the load can be anywhere. The point is, what position of W will cause maximum of all maximum bending moment, namely absolute maximum bending moment. So that is our concentration now. So we have to be clear about what we have discussed earlier and what we are going to discuss now. Right. So we are going to concentrate on absolute maximum bending moment. Right. First negative. So this is first positive, then negative. Right. Now, what is this net ordinate? This net ordinate, let us call it as O1. Then this net negative ordinate, we'll call it as O2. Right. Net positive ordinate, say O1. O1 or O positive, no problem. O1 or O positive is equal to the maximum ordinate is X into L minus X by L. From here to here, the ordinate is X into L minus X by L. Right. Minus. What we want is only this. So for this value, you have to subtract this value. This value is to be subtracted. For subtracting this, we know, so this is L by 2. H into Y, the maximum ordinate occurs at L by 2. Right. Now, for L by 2, the negative ordinate X into L minus X by L. For L by 2, the ordinate is X into L minus X by L. So, what is the value for X? So into x. So the total ordinate is this value. We have to subtract this value, minus value. So this we can get it from the negative ordinate. So from 0 to L by 2, this ordinate is X into L minus X by L. This is the, so what is the value for x? When for L by 2, if this is the value, what is the value for x? So this we have to simplify. When you simplify, you will get the equation. After simplification, actually this is due to W. So we can say W into, both are subjected to W only. So W into, so if you want to find out the maximum positive ordinate, you have to place the load where the ordinate is maximum. So W into this ordinate. Similarly, when you want to find out the negative maximum ordinate, you have to place the load where the load ordinate is maximum. The ordinate is net ordinate is maximum here. We have to place the load here. Therefore, W into this ordinate. That's all. So, W into positive ordinate, W into O1 will give you the maximum positive value at the section. Similarly, negative value. Now, we are not bothered about the maximum value at a section, absolute. Therefore, when you simplify this value, the equation will be M max positive is equal to M max positive equal to, on simplification, that will give W by L square into Lx minus x square, Lx minus x square into L minus 2x is equal to, so this is the value. So this equation, on simplification, we will be getting this equation, right? Now, this value, we want M max max. So for this to be maximum, for this to be maximum, the equation is that d M max by dx equal to 0. So, when we differentiate this with respect to x, so either we can expand this Lx into L, this into this, second term, you can have a simplified equation, or we can do it as it is, that is, we can go for u into dv by dx plus v into du by dx. So, on simplification, we will be getting one equation, right? So, when you differentiate dmx by dx, suppose we do it, it will be w by L square into u into dv by dx. That is, first term is Lx minus x square into dv by dx will become minus 2, plus second term v into du by dx, that is L minus 2x into du by dv into du by dx, that will be L minus 2x. So this you can expand, you will be getting a quadratic equation on expansion. Multiply these things and you will be getting a quadratic equation, and on solving the quadratic equation we will find two values for x. So x will be 0.789L and 0.211L. On solving the quadratic equation obtained from this, we will be getting two roots. One root is 0.21NL, or the other root is 0.789L. Right. Now, that means 1 minus 0.789 will be 0.211, or this max max will occur, the absolute maximum bending moment will occur at 0.21LL from both ends, 0.211L from both ends. So that is the value. So, if this is L, from here at 0.21L, 0.211L, you will have one maximum value. From here at the distance of 0.211L from the other side, right? So there you will have the max. Or from here, when it is measured, it is 1 minus 0.1 equal to 0.789L, or 0.21NL from both ends, right? So that is about the value of x, where the absolute maximum bending moment will occur. dmx by dx equal to 0 at 0.789L or 0.211L, right? Now this value 0.21L, if you want to get the absolute maximum positive bending moment, so you can say m max equal to w by l square into l into 0.21L minus 0.211L whole square into L minus. Here also we have to substitute, that is into L minus 2 into 0.211L. This, when we do it, we will get, so numerator we have L square, numerator we have L square, here also L square, here there is one L, so we will be getting L cube by L square will become L square, so here both L square and here also L square, this is L, so numerator will be getting L cube by L square is equal to L. So this on simplification will give m max, this is positive, m max positive equal to 0.09 equal to 0.096 W into L. This is the value. So this is the absolute maximum positive bending moment when a single concentric load moves from one end to the other end of the span. So this will occur on 0.211L from either supports. Therefore, you will find at the center it will be 0. So here you will have maximum, so one value. So this is the maximum value. This value equal to 0.211L, mean 0.096 WL, and here also this value also is 0.096 W into L. This is the absolute maximum positive bending moment. So due to a single concentrated load moving from one end, this is the absolute maximum positive bending moment. Absolute maximum positive bending moment will occur at 0.211L from either supports. So that we have to remember. Next we will concentrate on m max, absolute maximum bending moment negative. For getting this, we have to find out the net negative ordinate. Now this value is O2 is a negative ordinate. This is at a particular section, this is for a particular section x, right? So right, what is the net ordinate? O2 equal to total ordinate is x into L minus x by L. W will concentrate later. So due to unit load, it is x into L minus x by L. So this, when it is multiplied by W, will give the maximum negative ordinate at the section x under consideration, maximum negative bending moment for the given section x. Right, now we want the absolute maximum value. So when this is a section, whatever may be the value at the center is x in the L minus x by L only, but of course this ordinate will vary depending upon the value of x. Right, now this is x in the L minus x by L, this is x in the L minus x. Suppose we choose this section, then for that also we will have this is for the section and positive and this is negative. Right, now suppose we choose some other section, for this is the positive bending moment, positive, that is x in the L minus x by L. This ordinate will be depending on the value of x and the L minus x by L, and here also h into y is at the center only. So this is at the center, it is x in the L minus x by L. So this ordinate positive as well as negative will go on changing depending upon the value of x. Similarly here it is x, so depending upon that will vary. Now for what position of the load this positive ordinate is, the net ordinate is maximum. For what position of the load the net negative ordinate is maximum, that is our question. Right, so this will vary for different values of x. Right, now coming to negative, yes, so this is the total ordinate is w into the total ordinate. Now we want only the net value, we want only o2 equal to x in the L minus x by L minus this negative ordinate will be, see from here this is L minus x. For L minus x, if this ordinate is x in L minus x by L, what is the value for L by 2 from the right, the total ordinate is this minus, for L minus x, the ordinate is x into L minus x by L. What is the value for L by 2? So W into this net ordinate will give you the maximum negative bending moment at the section. So this we have to simplify. This expand, simplify, etc. We will find M max negative equal to, this is W into O2, right? W into O2 equal to, this on simplification will give W by 2L into LX minus 2X square. This in one or two lines of simplification will give this value. Right. Now, what is the absolute value? So, for this to be maximum, the condition is DM max by dx equal to 0. So this on differentiation equal to W by 2L into this on differentiation will give you L, this will give 4x. So this has to be equal to 0. DM max by dx will have to be equal to 0. So this, when this is taken to the right hand side, that will become 0. L minus 4x will be there. So L minus 4x equal to 0. L minus 4x equal to 0. Or L equal to 4x. Or x equal to L by 4. That is, at x equal to L by 4 from the ends, the maximum value will occur. The maximum, absolute maximum negative bending moment will occur at L by 4 from the supports. So now substituting x equal to L by 4 in this equation, L by 4, here also L by 4, and when we simplify, we'll find M max max negative equal to 0.0625 W into L, or it will be WL by 16. Now the point here is, this is the governing equation. This is the governing equation. It will find it is the power of x is 2. Power of x is 2. Therefore, that will be having a second degree variation. Similarly, the nature of the curve, the general equation, M max positive was W by L square into L minus Lx minus X square multiplied by L minus 2X. On multiplying, we'll have a cubic equation. So that will decide what is the nature of the curve, whether it is linear or second degree or third degree. See the equation, see the power of X. The highest power of X will decide the nature of the curve. So similarly here also, same thing. So this will occur at 0.25L from the supports. The maximum ordinate will occur at 0.25L. So from here it is 0.25L from the support, and here also it is 0.25L from the support. So this is negative, this is negative, negative. So this is, you can say WL by 16, or we can say 0.0625 W into L. So this is what is required. So we want only this diagram as far as the absolute maximum bending moment is concerned. This is due to a moving concentrated load W, single concentrated load moving from one end to the other end of the span. Right. Now, UDL problem we'll discuss later. Or UDL, same procedure, we got only one curve. I'll give you that also now. Due to UDL, both positive and negative value will be the same. That is, now here the value will be 0.01, this value equal to 0.01883 W L square, small W L square, and here also this ordinate is same. This is both plus as well as minus, positive as well as negative, it will be the same. Here positive, the location of absolute maximum positive bending moment is here, the location of absolute maximum negative bending moment is here. But as far as UDL W is concerned, the ordinate, both positive as well as negative ordinate, is same, 0.01883 W L square, and the distance also is same, 0.234 L. We will not discuss the derivation for this now. I will give only the final value, 234 L. So this is ILD for ILD for M max max, ILD for M max max due to small w. This is due to UDL. This is ILD for absolute maximum minimum moment. M max max due to W, concentrated load W, right? So this is the influence line diagram for ILD due to W. So these two diagrams, if it is known, we can straight away apply to a given problem. If UDL is given, you need not bother about the derivation, need not do any calculation, straight away use the diagram. This gives the location of maximum bending moment, both positive and negative, and also it gives the ordinate. You'll have to substitute small w and l, that will give you the maximum, absolute maximum bending moment due to uniformly distributed load. Similarly, the first diagram, if point load is given, straight away draw the diagram and you know the location of the absolute maximum positive bending moment, and also you know the ordinate of the absolute maximum bending moment. Straight away draw the diagram, substitute the data and get the value. That's all. That is the right. Now with this, we'll take up a small problem. Doing problem is simple. A suspension bridge of is of span 250 meters. The span L is equal to 250 meters, right? The cable of the bridge has a dip of 20 meters. The dip of the cable is equal to 20 meters, right? The span of the bridge is given and dip of the cable is given. Then the cable is stiffened by a 3-hinged stiffening girder with hinges at either end and also at the center. 3-hinged stiffening girder. Now, the dead load of the girder is 22 kilonewton per meter. Dead load of the girder equal to 22 kilonewton per meter. Then find the greatest positive and negative bending moments in the girder, positive and negative bending moments in the girder, when a single concentrated load of W is equal to 560 kilonewton. W equal to 560 kilonewton passes through it. Also find the maximum tension in the cable. So the span of the bridge is given as 250 meters, dip of the cable is given as 20 meters, it is stiffened by a 3-hinged stiffening girder with hinges at the ends and also at the center. There is a dead load of 22 kilonewton per meter. Find the greatest positive and negative bending, greatest positive and negative bending moments in the girder when a single concentrated load of 560 kilonewton passes through it. Also find the maximum tension in the cable. So here live load is given, single load W equal to 560 kilonewton moving from one end to the other end of the girder. Dead load is also given. Dead load is given as 22 kilonewton per meter. As we have discussed in the earlier sessions, we know the dead load will be directly transmitted to the cable. We need not bother about the dead load at all. Only uniformly distributed live load is given, you have to bother. So dead load will be directly taken by the cable. Dead load will not cause any bending moment or shear force in the girder. Right. Forget about dead load. Right. Coming to live load, there is a live load 560 kilonewton moving from one end to the other end. We know the influence line diagram for the absolute maximum positive and negative bending moment is as shown in the figure. Therefore, the diagram can be straight away drawn. Diagram can be straight away drawn. Right. Number one, you have to mention, you have to make a specific mention that this will directly taken by the cable. Therefore, you need not bother about it. Right. So, due to this, the ILD is this. This is the ILD due to ILD for absolute maximum bending moment due to a moving concentrated load W, right? Therefore M max max positive is equal to 0.096 W into L, whose value is equal to 0.096 W equal to 560, L equal to 250 meters. This will be the maximum bending moment. That value will be 13440 kilonewton meters. Straight away you can find out the absolute maximum bending moment. This occurs at point two one one L equal to 0.211 into 250 equal to 52.75 meters from either end. So what, just draw the diagram that is standard for moving concentrated load. So that will give you the formula also. So this is the absolute maximum positive bending moment. This will occur at 52.75 meters from either ends. Right, that is one problem. Coming to absolute maximum negative bending moment, M max max negative equal to, this is positive, negative equal to WL by 6 or 0.0625 WL, both are same, 0.0625 WL equal to 0.0625, W is 560, L equal to 250, and this value equal to 8750 kilonewton meter, occurring at 0.25 L, point L equal to 0.25 into 250 equal to 62.5 meters from either ends or from ends. From either end or from ends. That's all. Straight away draw the influence line for absolute maximum bending moment. Values are there, location is there. Simply find out the value. Absolute maximum positive bending moment, absolute maximum negative bending moment. So this is the first part of the question. So right, we now bother about the derivation. No, right, it's only application. Right. Right, now we have to find out the maximum tension in the cable. Now we know T max equal to root of V square plus H square. So these values we can find out either analytically, or for this also we can use ILD, right. Now, ILD for maximum tension, first you have to find out the ILD for the UDL, draw the ILD for UDL. We know ILD for uniformly distributed load will be given by a triangle, whose maximum value is 2 by L. This we have discussed in the earlier class. This is the ILD for W. ILD for W is this value equal to 2 by 250. L is 250, 2/250 equal to 1/125. 1/125. That is the maximum ordinate ILD for W. Now, we need not bother about the dead load. We are going to simply add this value, right? So, due to the live load. So, if you want to get the maximum UDL due to the point load, you have to place the load where the ordinate is maximum. So, this is the load. This load is 560. Therefore, the UDL due to live load will be given by load into ordinate. 560 into ordinate is 1/125. That will give you 4.48 kilonewton per meter. Kilonewton per meter. That is the uniformly distributed due to live load. Then this you can call it as WL or you can say PL. PL. Then P dead load is given in the problem. P dead load is 22. Therefore, P equal to P due to live load plus P due to dead load. P due to live load is 4.48. P due to dead load is directly given 22 plus 22 equal to 26.48 kilonewton per meter. So, this is the total UDL due to live load and dead load. We can either use the influence line diagram and get the UDL, or you can do it analytically. That's not a problem. So, that is the total UDL. So, from this total UDL, we can find out, VA B equal to VB equal to PL by 2. P equal to 26.48 into L is 250 by 2. Now, this value equal to 3310 kilonewton. 3310 kilonewton. So, now we have got the value of V. Right. So, one part of the problem is solved. Right. So, next is, we want the value of H. H is the horizontal tension. Horizontal tension, again, you can do it analytically, or using influence line. That is, ILD for the horizontal tension, again, will be a triangle having a maximum ordinate of L by 4D. This value already we know. This is L by 4D equal to L by 4 into dip of the cable is given at the beginning. Dip equal to 20 meters. The dip of the cable was given as 20 meters. So, 4 into 20. L is 250. L is 250 by 4 into 20. And this value will be 3.125. Right. Now, we have obtained the total UDL. So, this we can straight away use it. Now, for getting maximum value of the horizontal tension, this is ILD for H. ILD for horizontal tension. This we can do it analytically or you can do it using ILD itself. Right. Now, it is a UDL covering the entire span. UDL covering the entire span. So, what we can do is, so this we have to apply over the entire span. Now, this value equal to 26.48 kilonewton per meter. Kilonewton per meter. The span is 250 meters. Span is 250 meters. Therefore, horizontal tension equal to intensity of UDL, intensity of UDL into area of ILD below UDL. So, this is equal to intensity is 26.48 area equal to half into span is 250 into ordinate is 3.125. This will give the horizontal tension. Horizontal tension on substituting these values, 10343.75 kilonewton. So this is the horizontal tension. Horizontal tension is 343.75. Therefore, T max equal to root of V square plus H square. V is 3310 square plus H equal to 10343.75 square. So this value is equal to 10860.4. T max equal to 10860.4. So this is the maximum tension in the cable. So this is how we have to solve the problem. We know how to draw ILD for bending moment at a section, shear force at a section, ILD for UDL, ILD for horizontal tension. All these values we have discussed, and also with the numerical example we have discussed, and also for when a moving concentrated load, when a single concentrated load moves from one end to the other end, how to find out the absolute maximum positive bending moment and where it occurs, how to find out the absolute maximum negative bending moment and where it occurs. There was done a problem. So getting the value of horizontal tension or bending moment at a section or absolute maximum bending moment, you can do it for concentrated loads. Similarly, using the absolute maximum minimum diagram for UDL, simply you can draw the diagram, substitute the values and get the absolute maximum, positive and negative. As far as UDL is concerned, the absolute maximum positive and negative, the values are same, distance is also at 0.234L from, so we need not do the derivation, not be necessary. For given a numerical problem, straight away draw the diagram, you know the values, substitute the values of W and L and get the ordinates. I think that will be more than sufficient for doing problems on 3 inch Stefan Ingardus using influence lines. Thank you.